Let me know more about crop production and management. In India is depending maximum on agriculture. So agriculture is the main source of many people to live their life. So people are depending on advanced technology, and that is at very low percentage. But maximum of the people depending on the rainfall and growing the agriculture crops based on the season. This is common in India. Now, growing the crops is depending on the budget of the agriculture people. What are crops? When the plants of the same kind are cultivated at one place on a large scale is called a crop. For example, the crops of cereals, the crops of vegetables, the crops of fruits, and the crops of different food grains. Usually, these are grown on one particular area on a large scale and same kind, and that is referred as crops. The crops are classified into two types based on the season, that is Kharif crops, Rabi crops. What are Kharif crops? The crops which are sown in the rainy season are called Kharif crops. They usually grown from the month June to September. The crops are grown during June to September are paddy, maize, soybean, groundnut and cotton. And the other one is Rabi crops. The crops grown in the winter season from the month October to March are called Rabi crops. The crops grown in this season are wheat, grams, peas, mustard, linseeds. Beside these crops, the Indians, the maximum grow pulses and vegetables, and even the floriculture is attaining a major stage in the crop productions. There are different agricultural practices, and they are preparation of soil, sowing, adding manure and fertilizers, irrigation, protecting from weeds, harvesting, and storage. These are the some of the steps to be followed for agricultural purpose. Now, let me know in detail, step by step. The first step is preparation of soil. How to prepare the soil? The preparation of soil is the first step. As we all know, the topmost layer of the soil is very, very important for growing the crops, as the topmost soil gives support for the growth of microorganisms as well as for the plants. So, this is very important to loosen the topmost layer of the soil. When you loose the soil, it helps the roots to breathe easily, and also the roots develop into deeper, and thus it prevents soil erosion. When we loosen the soil, it helps to grow the earthworms and microbes present in the soil, as these organisms are the friends of the farmers. So, when we loosen the soil, the humus present in the soil will also easily degrade and distribute the nutrients to the plants. So, it is very important to prepare the soil before starting the crop. Now, how to loosen the soil? The process of loosening and turning of the soil is called tilling or flowing. This is done by using the floes. Floes are made up of wood or iron. If the soil is very dry, we may need watering before flowing. So, always when a shower attains, then easily the farmers will flow the field very easily. So, it is very necessary to break the crumbs present in the soil so the water can be better irrigated. After flowing, leveling of the soil is done with the help of leveler. So, this is how we can prepare the soil for the crop production. Tilling and flowing is a process where we can prepare the soil. So, this is the picture showing a person is flowing the crop field, loosening the soil. You can observe clearly what does the flower comprise. The flower comprise the flower shaft and the flower share. The flower share which penetrates the soil and it digs the soil out and makes it very loose. And this flowing shaft is supported to the beam, and the beam is given supported by the cattle, and thus a man will lead this cattle. Thus flowing takes place traditionally. And now tilling machines are taking a major role in flowing the soil. The tractors are mainly used in tilling and flowing of the soil. Flowing is done from ancient times in order to loose up the soil. And even flowing is done after adding the fertilizers and done to remove the weeds and to loosen the soil. So, flowing is followed from the ancient time till now in a different patterns in order to prepare the soil for sowing. Hoe is a simple tool which is used for removing weeds and for loosening the soil. It has a long rod of wood of iron and a broad bent plate of iron. Then it is fixed to one of its ends and works with a blade. Now, this is the picture showing the hoe instrument or device, and you can see the tractor used as a cultivator in order to flow the soil. Now, after flowing, it is very important step is sowing of the seeds. Sowing is important part of crop production. Before sowing, good quality, clean and healthy seeds are selected, and thus 80% to 90% crop will get success only by the selection of the seeds. The very good method is separating the healthy seeds from the damaged one. Thus, we select the seeds for the sowing. Now, how to sow the seeds? When you see the image, it was traditional method for sowing the seeds, which is supported with a funnel, and funnel is filled with the seeds, and the cattle helps in dragging and flowing, and thus the seeds are uniformly sowed in the field. Seed drill. Nowadays, seed drill is used for sowing with the help of tractors. The seeds are uniformly at equal distance and depth will be seeded by using seed drill with the help of tractors. And next very important step is adding manure and fertilizers. The substance which are added to the soil in the form of nutrients for healthy growth of the plants are called manure and fertilizers. The continuous cultivation of crops makes the soil poor in nutrients. Therefore, the farmers add to manure to the fields to replenish the soil with nutrients, and this process is called manuring. Improper and insufficient manuring results in weak plants, and hence manure the crop fields regularly. Use of fertilizers which are rich in particular nutrient, and these fertilizers are produced in factories. They are urea, ammonium sulfate, superphosphate, potash, NPK. Use of fertilizers, of course, it gives better yield of the crops, but when we use at maximum extent, the use of fertilizers has helped the farmers to get better yield of crops. But when it exceeds, definitely it leads to the pollution. We have to use the manure only to improve the texture and water retaining capacity and to supply the nutrients for the plants. So it is always to use organic manure will be better than the chemical manure. And even we can follow the crop rotation. And what is this crop rotation? Earlier, farmers used to grow legumes as fodder in one season and wheat in the next season. This helps in the replenishment of the soil with nitrogen. Farmers are being encouraged to adopt this practice. This is how the nutrients are supplied to the plants. And even sometimes we can use rhizobium bacteria present in the nodules of roots of leguminous plants, which fix atmospheric nitrogen. So this is how we can manure. Fertilizers are man-made and it is inorganic salts. Fertilizers are prepared in factories. Fertilizers does not provide any humus to the soil. Fertilizers are very rich in plant nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. And manure, the organic manure, is a natural substance obtained by the decomposition of cattle dung and plant residues. Manure can be prepared in the fields. Manure provides a lot of humus to the soil. Manure is relatively less rich in plant nutrients. So, it is always better to use manure as they are eco-friendly, and fertilizers somehow they may damage the ecosystem in future. The main advantages of manure. The organic manure is considered better than the fertilizers as they enhance water holding capacity. It makes the soil very porous, helps in gaseous exchange. It increases the number of friendly microbes. It improves the texture of the soil. Hence, it is better to use organic manure all the times. Irrigation, that is need of the water to the crops. Water is important for proper growth and development. Water is absorbed by the plant roots along with water, minerals and fertilizers. Plant contains nearly 90% of water, and water is essential because the germination of seeds does not take place when there is no water, and even the nutrients dissolved in water, and thus it is transported to the plant. And water protects the crop from the frost and hot air currents. To maintain the moisture of the soil for healthy crop growth, fields have to be watered regularly. So, supply of the water to the crops at regular intervals is called irrigation. The supply of water to the crops at regular intervals is called irrigation. The irrigation methods make it vary, and the sources are wells, tube wells, ponds, lakes, rivers, dams, and canals. These are the major source of water. Now look at the picture. The picture says the different sources of water. Now how to irrigate the plants or the crops, and this is a different modes of the water systems to supply the water to the crop fields. Moat is one of the type, that is pulley system. Chain pump, the other type. Deckli is one more type. Rahat is the other type. These are the ways to pump the water and to supply to the crop fields. The modern methods of irrigation, that is sprinkler system and drip system. This is a sprinkler system method. It is more useful on uneven land where sufficient water is not available. The perpendicular pipes having Rotating nozzles on the top are joined to the main pipeline at regular intervals, and when the water is allowed to flow through the main pipe under pressure with the help of a pump, it escapes from the rotating nozzles. It gets sprinkled on the crop as if it is raining. So thus it keeps the crops always fresh and it avoids the loss of water. It is used in insects. And even dried neem leaves are used for storing food grains at home, for storing large quantities of grains in big godowns. Specific chemical treatments are required to protect them from pests and microbes. So, this is about the storage unit. And there is one more very important concept in agriculture, that is animal husbandry. Now, many people living in the coastal areas consume fish, and many non-vegetarian people consume the poultry, the sheep, goat as a major food. So, animals are reared at home or in a farms, provided with the proper food, shelter and care, and this is done on a large scale, and that is called animal husbandry. So this about a minimum information about crop production and management. Every individual should have the minimum knowledge on this. So at last, don't forget to hit on subscribe button of Go Green with Jyoti.